Hi, welcome to Kathadi. In this series on the story of everyday objects, we'll be looking at one invention or discovery every month. This month, we'll be looking at the story of the ballpoint pen. Some objects around us are so common that we seldom stop to wonder how or why they came to be. Today, we look into the story of the invention of the ballpoint pens. The story starts in the year 1888. John.J.Loud, a lawyer cum leather tanner, was looking for something to mark on leather. Fountain pens were not useful to him and pencils were too soft on the leather. As they say, necessity is the mother of invention. He invented a pen such that there was a tube carrying ink and a tiny steel ball bearing at the end of it. The ball could rotate freely, but it could neither fall in nor fall out. This pen was quite useful to him and he even patented it. But the problem was that this was very hard to write on paper and would cause leaking. Later, many people worked on improving Loud's design of the ballpoint pen. The first among them to be successful was László, a Hungarian newspaper editor. He, along with his brother George, modified the design of the ballpoint pen and included an ink that was viscous and quickly drying. So this solved the problem of leaking. Their pens, called Bíró pens, became hugely popular for daily use in Argentina. The next breakthrough came when Milton Reynolds, an American businessman, saw the Bíró ballpoint pen during his visit to Argentina. He came back home and modified the design of the ballpoint pen and marketed his own pens called Reynolds Rocket. The pens were highly marketed as the only pens that could write underwater and could write for 15 years without refilling. The caption, "Got a rocket in your pocket," became highly famous. Even in India, we have different versions of the Reynolds ballpoint pens. Now the market is flooded with so many varieties of ballpoint pens. So how do these pens really work? Let's take a closer look. We know an important part of the ballpoint pen is the refill. The refill consists of the plastic tube which holds the ink and the nib. When we open out the nib, we can clearly see the socket which holds the ball and a very tiny ball attached to the end of the socket. As we write, this tiny ball rotates at the end of the socket and draws ink from the refill. Here's a magnified picture of the nib of the ballpoint pen. As you can see, the ball draws ink from the cartridge and writes on paper. Here's a simple analogy. The bottle of roll-on works on the same principle as the ballpoint pen. The tube is filled with liquid and at the end of the tube is a ball which rotates freely at the end. As the ball rotates, it draws liquid from the tube just as the ball of the ballpoint pen draws liquid. Isn't it so fascinating that something so common has such an interesting story behind it? Thank you for watching and we'll be back with another interesting story next month.